Hi, I'm Landon Goldfarb, Biomedical Market Manager here at Instron. Today we're going to take a deep dive into the mechanical testing of insulin delivery devices. Diabetes is quickly becoming one of the world's greatest public health crises. Over time, the complexity and volume of treatment devices has increased, leading to expanded requirements for mechanical testing. To start, we're going to take a look at the device that has been most associated with diabetes treatment in the last 20 years, the insulin pen. Despite their improved usability compared to a traditional syringe and vial, they are internally complex devices that require significant testing to ensure they function properly. In addition to an evaluation of the finished device, there are also many different components that need to be tested in isolation. One component that requires testing is the attachable dual-sided needle, which is tested in accordance with ISO 11608-2. This standard defines the torques required to assemble and remove the needle, as well as the strength of the connection between the needle and the hub. To perform this, you need a test system capable of applying both axial and torsional loads. The most challenging requirements apply to testing the insulin pen as a finished product. Per ISO 11608-1 and 5, the performance and usability of the device need to be evaluated before it can be released to market. Dose accuracy is by far the most critical part of this evaluation, as it directly relates to the efficacy of the treatment. Insulin pens are usually variable dose devices, meaning that the dose can be adjusted by rotating the knob on the top of the device. Measured accuracy is required for a minimum, maximum, and midpoint dosage to ensure performance is guaranteed across the full range of deliverable volumes. Integration of a precision balance on the system is required to capture the delivered volume and determine the dose accuracy. Per the 2022 release of ISO 11608, primary functions of the device are also required to be tested. These can include dial dose torque and cap removal force, as both can have an impact on the user experience. In recent years, many patients have shifted towards wearable delivery devices and integrated glucose sensors to make their treatment as straightforward as possible. Similar to testing a standard insulin pen, they require evaluation of the activation force and delivered dose. The main challenge lies in the radically different form factor of these devices. The variation in size and shape means that test systems have to be extremely flexible, with additional capabilities related to device activation and wearable adhesives. Some devices have activation buttons that are not aligned with the needle. An adjustable load cell design alleviates this issue by accommodating that offset. Visualization of the dosage rate and profile are required to ensure the full drug volume is delivered while maximizing patient comfort. ISO 11608-6 leaves significant room for interpretation when developing your own adhesive test protocol, so ensuring your system can adapt to perform applications such as variable angle peel or tack testing, all under different physiological conditions, is absolutely critical for understanding product performance. This has been just a brief introduction to some of the testing that needs to be done on insulin delivery devices. As demand continues to spur innovation, testing requirements will continue to evolve as devices become more sophisticated and user-friendly. If you want to start preparing your lab now with flexible test systems capable of growing alongside industry requirements, visit our website or give us a call. Thanks for watching.